Ooh, die roll. Always love winning the die roll. Ha! Seven, six land. You know, that is one issue with this deck is a lot of opening hands just look very bad because you know you're playing a lot of expensive cards in your deck. Usually, if there was like an Ugin and I don't know, maybe like a Downfall or something, I'll probably keep. But yeah, it's pretty hard to justify keeping seven lands, six lands Ugin. So we'll ship that. Hope we get something a little bit better. And yeah, I don't really want to go to five, so I'm gonna keep this. This hand definitely needs a lot of help, but there's the Miser's Drown in Sorrow to help with the mono red matchup. I think you know this is specifically for the Magic Online metagame. There's a lot more mono red in on Magic Online than there is in real life, I think. And looks like we are playing potentially the mirror, because that's like the most fun thing everybody. That's what everybody wants to see, right? Just the old school control mirror. Hey, look, he might have to discard. At some point, I might just cast a Drown in Sorrow to scry. Right now, we're not fetching any lands because we just want to draw more and more lands. Oh man, he missed a land drop and hit two in a row. How lucky. I also don't want to cast Jace's Ingenuity because it's really important to resolve your card draw spells. So we want him to be the first person to basically flinch. Wow. It's pretty lucky. Rattled off three in a row. Yeah, that's an Ashiok. Alright, he hit. Hopefully some removal spells. Perilous Vault, Ingenuity, Temple of the Seed. Okay. And now we're going to Downfall. He's got two Disdainful Strokes in the deck, so I don't really want to use my Jace's Ingenuity yet. And, you know, getting rid of the Ashiok is something that I probably want to be doing. Let's see. I'm just debating whether or not I want to cast a Drown in Sorrow here to scry. They have nothing that's good with this. It builds Delve. I am going to fetch an island, and I do believe that I'm going to cast a Drown in Sorrow. And I'm gonna put this on the bottom. I want lands. It's very unlikely that he has another Ashiok in his deck, or in his hand, because they only tend to play two in the main deck. And we have four downfalls, but if he plays an Ashiok here, it would be unfortunate. We're trying to set up and play the percentages. We want to hit our lands. Boom, that's a good one. And yeah, we'll keep all the lands. Nothing we can do there. I hope he doesn't take Pearl Lake Ancient. It's really hard to win if they Thoughtseize the Pearl Lake Ancient. It's kind of one of the one of the weaknesses of this version. You know, we have Ugins, but it's fairly easy for him to deal with. Yeah, and he got the Pearl Lake Ancient, so you know, this is going to be tricky, definitely. So he's got right now he's got Dissolve and Disdainful Stroke mana up. We just, you know, we need to wait to draw our Thoughtseizes, basically. But generally, the control matchup, the first person to flinch loses. Like, unless we're like enough behind where we have to just go for it. I think our opponent just like forgot to play a land. Maybe that's what happened. All right, we drew the Thoughtseize. Let's see if we can make something happen. He might just dissolve it. He should probably, if he has a dissolve, he should probably dissolve it. Okay. Ooh. Interesting. All right. So now this is actually an interesting, interesting turn. Now what I want to do is cast Dictu Time. I want to cast Dictu Time and find a Hero's Downfall for the Pearly Ancient to make him return it. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to respond. At this point, we have a good amount of lands. Let's maximize the chances of drawing Dictu Time. Sorry, Hero's Downfall. And let's go blue, blue. Delve everything. Whew. Those are a lot of goodies. Wish we can cast the Crux of Fate at instant speed. Wow. Alright. It's really unfortunate that we were not able to find the Hero's Downfall, though. Alright, well, dissolve is very good. Very important. What else do I want? Dissolve for sure. Dictu Time is going to be better than Jace's Ingenuity. The question is it better? Is it going to be better than Ugin? Do we want the Ugin right now? I'm not sure that it does a whole lot right now. So we can just look to draw it later. And finding answers seems more important. I don't think I want the Crux of Fate. Alright, Pearl Lake resolves, unfortunately. What is your hand? I see. Alright. So, let's write this down here. I guess we should dock this. Ugin, Downfall, Stroke, Dig, Light. How are we going to win this game? Basically by resolving our Dictu Time. We don't care about his Ugin at all, so he can have that. Bioblight obviously stays. Downfall is also okay for the time being. So we care about between the Disdainful Stroke and the Dictu Time. Dictu Time, we should be able to counter. Well, let's see. What I can do is take his Dictu Time, cast an Ingenuity. Let's see. What's also concerning is that, yeah, the Pearl Lake Ancient is going to kill us fairly soon. But, let's see, 3, 4, 5. Let's see if we can sequence this properly. So we're going to take the Disdainful Stroke. So we're going to, if we take the Disdainful Stroke, we can't cast anything at the end of his turn. And we can Bioblight the Pearl Lake Ancient just to shrink it. And then on our turn, we can cast basically Dig Through Time for 6 mana and still keep up Disdainful Stroke. Alright. Yeah. Alright. We're planning out the next few turns. So we're gonna probably be taking 2 hits from the Pearl Lake Ancient. Actually, do we need to shrink it this turn? Let's see. It'll be for 5. No, we don't need to shrink it. Actually, we can shrink it. We can do it for six and then still cast stroke. I'm gonna play it, but it's not gonna do a whole lot. We want to. Yeah, we are definitely in some trouble. going to be stroking this. Jace's ingenuity. Going to be dissolving that. That on the bottom. Alright, we're just gonna Bioblight here. I guess if we Bioblighted the turn before, we could have actually been able to dig through time, but let's just take a little less damage here, because he's going to get one more attack in. There's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lands. Okay. I wonder if he has a dissolve. We know he has Downfall, Blight, Ugin. Alright, so. See, he has Ugin, Downfall, Blight. I kind of want to cast my spells on my turn so that he can't pump the Prolake Ancient if he has a Dissolve. But that should not be enough to kill me, though. What happens if I cast Jace's Ingenuity? I just played a land this turn, which is not good. Well, yeah, we need to cast a dig. Feels like he drew a dissolve. Oh, nope, nope, nope. Alright, that's good for us. You know, Heroes, Downfall, Thoughtseize could be the answer, but then he has Ugin as well. So, I mean, double Heroes, Downfall is also reasonable, because then we have an answer to the Ugin, because we can't counter the Prolake Ancient, and if he plays it again, we can always counter it again. So, yeah, because, I mean, I could also get, let's see, he has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, he has to return 3, goes to 6. I could also get Heroes, yeah, I can afford to take the 3, yeah, I'm just going to take 2 Downfalls. This time I'll go on his upkeep. He could replay it, but if he replays it, then we downfall it again, he's just not going to have any lands in play, which is going to be really good for us. So yeah, like he could float 3 mana, bounce 3 lands, replay it, then he's going to be on 5, and then we downfall it again. And he's going to think we're very unlikely to have another downfall. And, you know, he's probably going to have to let it go. In which case, we can cast Jace's Ingenuity and hopefully try to claw back from this. Also, clock is a big factor here, so I need to actually play. I think he's going to go, yeah. What? He had a dig through time? Alright. Alright, I mean, that's fine too. Like, he's not going to be able to replay the Prolake Ancient, so. I think the 2 downfalls were still good. I suppose we could have done it on our turn. Yeah, he could find a dissolve here. So Ugin, Downfall, Blight, and two cards. Alright, in response, we're going to Downfall again. I think he just has to let it die. He cannot afford to lose three more lands here. Or he can counter. What is this? Oh, wow. Alright. The Prolic Ancient is too important. He can't play anything, though, with this mana, though. I guess he can play a Swamp and Thoughtseize me. He might want to keep up Disdainful Stroke, though. I'm not sure. Alright, so PLA, 6 lands. Well, whatever. Okay, he's keeping up Stroke. Oh, well, I have an Urborg. Ugin, Downfall, Blight, PLA. Okay, so there goes the Blight. Lands. It's kind of like we upheavaled him. Yeah, I think we play the waiting game again. I feel like, you know, him casting Addict of Time and leaving up the 2 mana, there's just a really high chance that he has Disdainful Stroke. But, you know, we've managed to stabilize. Oh, he found another Addict of Time. Okay. Alright, now we can play Jace's Ingenuity in response. Hope to draw some stuff. Alright. And we're going to dissolve this. And hope to find some goodies. That is not a goodie. I wonder if he plays Perilous Faults. I should be fetching these lands. We don't really want to draw any more lands. We have we have 2 islands. Oh, we have some swamps left. Obviously, we should just be fetching islands because we both have an Urborg in play. So he's got Prolic Ancient. Oh man, still drawing lands. All right. Here comes a Prolic Ancient. Ooh, oh, Jace's Ingenuity. Huh. Ugin, Downfall, Prolic Ancient. Is this the time to go for it? Yeah. Because with the Jace Ingenuity, he has a good chance of drawing stuff. So let's just do that. Alright, we hit a Dissolve and a Dig Through Time. And let's put on top. I'm not gonna cast Dig Through Time. Are those all of our downfalls? That is all of our downfalls. Maybe we should have countered that, actually. Because now he's going to play a Pearl-Lake Ancient, and if we don't have the hero's downfall up, we're going to be in trouble. I guess we can still... We can just look for a Perilous Vault. Yeah, so... we'll downfall this... draw for turn, draw the dissolve, fetch a swamp, dig through time, we're at 4. If we draw a if we find a Thoughtseize, that'd be great. Ooh, that's perfect. What do you have? Pearl-Lake Ancient, Hero's Downfall, and Crux of Fate. So we're going to take the Pearl-Lake Ancient. He has Hero's Downfall and Crux of Fate. So I'm going to wait on the Ugin. I'm going to wait on the Ugin for one turn. Downfall, Crux. Whew. I don't mind drawing the Radiant Fountain. If he has, oh, he drew a counterspell? God. Alright. Looks like we're just gonna get decked. I guess we do have one more Ugin, but it's gonna be difficult. What is he doing? Oh, my upkeep downfall? Sure. Have we gone through all of our digs? I'm surprised he's holding on to his downfall. What is he waiting for? We've hit... one, two, we have no dissolves left. We do have a Disdainful Stroke. All right, here it is. Use Ingenuity in response. And yeah, can't do anything. Just run that out there. Need to draw that Ugin. This turn. Okay. Want to Thoughtseize now, because it's not going to be that much better in the future turns. And we needed to draw it like this for next turn to actually be able to kill him. How many downfalls does he have left? He has a lot of downfalls left, so this is going to be tough. This is going to be tough, but you know, at least we have a chance. This is our other win condition. Getting the Pearl-Lake Ancient Thoughtseize is a big game. So we have 8 draw steps. That's 8 times 3. Actually, that's 24 damage. As long as he doesn't draw an answer to the Ugin. But the deck is just all answers to Ugin, or his own threat, or card draw. Like, I guess if he just draws only counter spells. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we can't do anything about that. Alright. right, so we can Ugin for 3, and then we have 4 turns. That's 12 damage. Yeah, we lose. All right. The mirror in a nutshell, boys. You got us. Yep. All right. Yeah. I guess that's why Ashok's okay, because you get to draw a couple cards and it's easier to deal with Ugin. And yeah, like Pearl Lake Ancient is the way you're supposed to try to win. So after sideboard, it's a little bit better. You have a lot more counters to protect your win conditions, and you bring in additional win conditions in Tasigur as well. So it's, you know, it's far easier to like be able to win the game after sideboard. So let's keep all the downfalls. Let's board in the Read the Bones, Negates, Strokes, and where's the Thoughtseize? Oh, there it is. All right, let me think here. Yeah, it's one of the, this is one of the things where everything is good. You want to hit all your land drops. It's probably just Perilous Fault. Yeah, everything else is just a better card in the matchup, so we'll try like this. Yeah, because we know the matchup, we can just keep this. Definitely want Negate so that we can deal with the turn 3 Ashiok. Kind of hoping if he has Thoughtseize that he Thoughtseizes now. Darn. Represent that dissolve. Right now we're not fetching. Basically with this deck you want to at least hit like 8 or 9 lands, but you don't want to miss land drops until you get to that point. Then you want to draw spells. I should have just played Swamp. That's not going to be that important. All right, double negate, that's nice. He might try to play an Ashiok with negate backup, I don't know. We want blue sources right now. We're kind of choked on blue. Oh yeah. The control mirror. Don't you guys love the control mirror? Look at this. Sitting here doing nothing. Looks like I'm gonna miss a land drop here. Oh, that's a good one. Like, just the most excited I've ever been to draw Dismal Backwater on turn 8 of the game. At this point, we need to hit some land drops. I'm going to try to run out of Jace's Ingenuity. We have 4 card draw spells in our hand. Dig through times are better. Just at least try to burn through his counter spells. And Tasigur is just not a card you play until very late in the game, where basically like he just costs 1 mana and you can activate it like twice. I wonder if he's going to cast his own card draw spell. Looks like he is. Is he going to go full delve? keeping up dissolve, sure. Alright, well, we're gonna try to negate this, then he's gonna counter back, and then we're gonna dig on our turn, and... yeah, he's gonna counter back. Oh, he's not countering back. Okay. He could still very easily have a counter. Let's see. Alright, I need to think through this kind of quickly, but 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. I can play a Tassigur and try to draw a counter spell. No, that's not good, because then you can just play Nugan. The fact that he let that resolve, though, I'm just gonna wait. All right, let's start. I'm doing this to try to like represent a negate or a counterspell. I could just tap out. It's like, what are those last three cards in his hand? Yeah, all right, that could have been a missed delve. That definitely could have been a missed delve. How many counter spells do you have? Yeah, time is an issue too, so I'm not like fully able to think out everything. But I think, yeah, perhaps the one window to draw cards was a turn where he was kind of low on mana, and that was the time to pull the trigger on the victory time. And you know, if he had the other stroke, then yeah, that sucks. But alright, now we're just going to pass. You know, we're guaranteed to get a good spell this turn, so the Tassigur is at least going to replace itself, and Negate is, you know, likely one of those cards that we would have dug for. He could just have a Hero's Downfall here, but... if he does, I mean, it's fine. At least he replaces himself. All right, here, actually, yeah, okay. I was gonna use the Tasker's response ability in response, but then, you know, he'll give me the negate and just take the negate, so we'll just let him Thoughtseize and see what he does here. He's used three of his disdainful strokes. Hmm. You gave me negate, huh? Tasigur incoming. I mean, the window is open right now. This is the turn. But if he plays a Tasigur, he can't use it this turn. And he's going to have no cards in his yard. Oh, never mind. He could also play Ashiok. So. His Thoughtseize's downfall. His hand could be any number of counters, hand disruption, card draw, or threat. And, okay, alright. He gave us negate and then passed? That seems really strange. Maybe he just has like two dissolves or something. So he has Tasigur. We're gonna dig in response. Yeah, we'll keep up this much mana. Then we're going to negate that. We're basically looking for a Disdainful Stroke. And his last card is Dissolve. Okay. That's fine. All right, well, we're ahead. We're ahead. He's got no cards in hand. We're going to play an Ugin and minus six it. So. Those are good draws. He just needs to not draw Prolake Ancient. That's like the card that would be most annoying. Let's stroke that. Alright, dissolve that. Bottom. I'm gonna wait one more turn before I Thoughtseize him. Is this an Ashiok? Like, there's no reason to just Thoughtseize when he has one card in hand. If he plays a threat, you know, then we can set up a downfall with the Thoughtseize. So. Oh, okay. Another dig through time. Yeah. Man, we were just about to get to. We're getting so close to the ultimate, too. This is a fun match. I think we both kind of made small mistakes in this game. You know, like he shouldn't have fought over the Tasigur there, because he knows we have an Ugin in our hand. Like. Perilous Fault. So, it's colorless, which is unfortunate. But I'm going to Thoughtseize him. He can't stick through time, so. Another dig through time? Dissolve and Jace's Ingenuity. Jeez. This is tough. I think Ingenuity is probably going to be better than Dissolve. I'm just going to have to wait on the Ugin. See, but he does. Oh, let's actually look at how many counters he's been through. Three strokes, two negates, and one dissolve. So he still has three dissolves, a potential negate, and another stroke, and Thoughtseizes that he can draw. Alright. Let's just make sure that this is exile each permanent converted mana cost X or less that's one or more colors that is non-colored. Alright. Well, he's gonna have to at least use it on his turn. Alright, so we know he's got the dissolve in hand. Yep, not a lot we can do there. Alright. Because we know that he doesn't have a whole lot right now, we probably just need to go for it here. You know, he's got two. Oh god. Tassiger. Jeez. We'll do that. Get him to scry first. See what he did. He put it on top. All right. Now we are going to downfall it. So he's got two mana up, and we'll give him Thoughtseize. It'd be kind of awkward if it wasn't end of turn. Alright, he goes to 4. If he Thoughtseizes, he goes to 2. He needs to draw Thoughtseize into Hero's Downfall. Alright, he's dead. Whew, what a game. What a match. These resolves. Whew. Alright, so one more game. Wow. Alright, so yeah, these heroes' downfalls are specifically just for Tassiger and Ashiok. It could also be used for, of course, the Pearlleak Ancients. You know, Ugin isn't. Surprisingly, Ugin is just not that great in this matchup. It is a win condition, but it's really hard to actually try to win with Ugin, and, you know, maybe that's the reason to play something like an Ashiok. I could also play maybe, you know, like a Grind Clock or something. Something along those lines. Maybe a Liliana, although Liliana doesn't do a whole lot. So, anyways, because he has Tassiger and the Pearlleak Ancient, it is possible to keep in one Perilous Vault just to make sure that we have an answer to his stuff. But then, like, what would we cut? Would we cut one of the Ugins? Because it's just, like, it doesn't seem that good in this matchup. You're not really wiping anything. You are killing a Tassiger, I guess. You're setting up scenarios where you can do that. But yeah, I might need to rethink how I want to be sideboarding for this matchup. But I will try the one Perilous Vault. Go a little bit more defensive while I'm on the draw. Just a tiny bit. All right. Keeping this hand. Yeah, I'm just gonna lead off with some Thoughtseizes here. Whoa, show me the rest of your hand. Alright, so he's got a big PLA, Mire, Fountain, Island, Swamp. We're taking the Pearlleak Ancient. Games go long, man. But I will also take the dig. Actually, let me think here. No, because if he top decks Ashiok, it's really bad for us. I'm actually going to wait. That was pretty sweet, you know? Just kind of making sure we're on top of this. So now we have one turn to dodge the Ashok, but if he does, then we can play Dig Through Time. I'm going to play the Dismal Backwater here. All right, we know he has nothing. Oh, no, we can't cast the Dig Through Time yet. He has Meyer Island Swamp. Okay, I think we should just go for the card draw here. He has Island Swamp that we know of, and X. If it's a card draw spell, well, yeah, if it has to be exactly Dig Through Time. If it's Jace's Ingenuity, I mean, we're on equal footing, but unfortunately for us, our opponent is, But he can't counter this, though. He can cast Dig Through Time, but he can't counter this. So we're still okay, actually. But yeah, that's unfortunate. Was a good draw. What did you find? Dissolve Negate. I'm gonna take the Dissolve because it gives him a Scry. Negate Island Swamp. Negate. And let's play the Temple of Deceit. And we'll keep a Negate, yeah. So there's no reason to cast. I mean, we can cast a Dig Through Time on our turn, but actually, should we be casting Dig Through Time on our turn? No, we're good. We're good. We gotta play quick too. We don't have a lot of time. It's his island. Let's cast. Let's cast the Dig Through Time here. Let's negate up. Honor his upkeep. Let's cast Dig Through Time. Let's just overwhelm him with card advantage. Jace's Ingenuity and Disdainful Stroke. Don't need Tasker right now, but I will fetch because we have two Taskers on the bottom. Gotta play fast. fine. I probably should, maybe I should take a downfall there. Actually, he has no cards in hand. There's like, yeah, down, yeah, for that reason I should have taken downfall. Oh, well, there's a downfall. Although we got his Prolic Ancient already, I think. Yeah. There's no way he has two. So all right, we got it, boys. Bam. That was a tight one. That was a tight one. But I like control mirrors. I think we could have maybe sequenced it some of our stuff a little bit differently, but I'm glad that we were able to not die to the Ashiok that one game. So, yeah, round one in the books.